Welcome to the Eyes on the Sky series, an update about current astronomy, space science, and sky events. I'm astronomer Richard Monda, and this is Eyes on the Sky for September 2019. The brilliance of the giant planets is eye-catching in the evening sky this September, but the smallest planets are missing from the night. The Moon, however, starts September as a thin, three-day-old crescent in Virgo, found low in the west about an hour after sunset. The next evening, the Moon is on the opposite side of Virgo, and above Spica, the constellation's brightest star. By September 3rd, the Moon has entered Libra and waxed to a broader crescent. It's found between the stars Zumanesh Shamali and Zubin el-Janubi, names that mean the northern claw and the southern claw of the scorpion. Apparently, at one time, Scorpius extended into what is now Libra the Scales, the only non-living picture of the zodiac. By September 4th, the six-day-old moon has reached the western side of Libra, and the wide crescent is across from the stars that make the head of the scorpion. The moon glides above Scorpius during the evening of September 5th and reaches first quarter at 11:10 p.m. That night, the moon makes a triangle with the scorpion's heart, the red star Antares, a red supergiant so large that the orbits of the inner planets would fit inside it. The triangle is completed that night with bright Jupiter. Jupiter's immense atmospheric storm, the Great Red Spot, has been changing. During the 1990s, the Hubble telescope first noticed that the spot was shrinking. Once, almost three Earths could fit across the Great Red Spot. Now, it's hardly bigger than one Earth. As it shrinks, it has been growing taller, like a mass of worked clay. In May, amateur astronomers noticed reddish material untangling from the Red Spot and being carried downstream. As the storm rises, it may be encountering winds that are pulling material away. On September 6th, the now waxing gibbous moon is high above the stars that make the cat's eyes of the scorpion's tail. When first seen before sunrise in February, these two stars are a celestial harbinger of spring. On September 7th, the 70% lit gibbous moon glides above the stars of Sagittarius and is to the west of Saturn. The next evening, the gibbous moon is east of the ring planet. Over the next 3 days, the moon drifts into the water region of the autumn sky, through Capricornus the seagoat, and then on the 12th, into Aquarius the water bearer. That night, the moon is far above the lone bright star in the southeast, Fomalo. The next night, the moon is on the eastern side of Aquarius. On September 14th, the moon becomes full at 12:33 a.m., and this is the harvest moon. If we look at the moon's positions in the sky around the time of harvest moon, we can see that its path makes a somewhat shallow angle with the horizon. This means that the moon is rising about 25 minutes later each day rather than its average 50 minutes. That lights up the field sooner, allowing the harvest to continue into the evening. About 30 minutes before daybreak on the 19th, the waning gibbous moon has moved to the winter stars of Taurus the Bull and is towering in the south below the Pleiades star cluster. On September 20th, the 68% lit moon appears with the stars that make the bull's face, the Hyades star cluster. It's also across from Aldebaran, the red giant star of Taurus. The next morning at dawn, the moon is near the eastern horn of the bull, and the lunar globe reaches last quarter at 10:41 p.m. later that day. On September 23rd, all locations on the Earth have equal day and night. This is the autumnal equinox and occurs at 3:50 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. This moment is the start of fall in the northern hemisphere and spring in the southern. By the 25th, the waning crescent moon is approaching a sickle shape of stars, the backward stellar question mark of Leo the Lion. The next morning, the thinning crescent is near Regulus, the bright star of Leo. Then in the dawn sky of September 27th, an ultra-thin lunar crescent hangs low in the east by the star Denebola. The next cycle of lunar phases starts with the new moon at 2:26 p.m. on September 28th. Then the moon is back in the evening sky on the last day of the month as a thin crescent low in the west-southwest. I'm Hudson Valley Community College astronomer Richard Monda, reminding you to keep your eyes on the sky.